It's time for the December Horror Pack, your fan mail, and what I got for Christmas. Let's do this. What is up, guys? As of this recording, it's Christmas Day, and it's time to unveil the December Horror Pack. Also, I'm going to open your fan mail, and then I'm going to show you guys what I got for Christmas. This t-shirt happens to be one of them. Barry kicks ass, and this is from Halloween 6, of course, and I freaking love this damn shirt. Big thank you to my wife for getting me this. But I got a few more shirts, some other items, show you those too. But anyway, first off, let's get into the Horror Pack. Horror Pack is a monthly DVD or Blu-ray service, all horror-based, and every month they come to your door for a certain price, depending on which format you want, DVD or Blu-ray. But also you'll get limited editions, you get independent type stuff, you get upper crust, big studio type stuff, but it's all horror. So anyway, let's get into this month's haul and see what we got. First off, right out the gate, we got Raven Banner Releasing Presents. Oh, this is Z. I reviewed this movie actually, yeah. Yeah, this is a movie about the evil kid, or it could be an evil kid. I'm not gonna give it away. Check out my review though. But this was a decent movie. It was on Shudder. It was a Shudder exclusive, actually. There was another movie that came out recently, too, that also has, you know, I guess an evil kid type deal. Or has a similar plot, and I think it's Come Play, and I haven't seen that yet. But yeah, glad to have this one on Blu-ray. Next up, we got The Conjuring 2. Good, worthy sequel to the first movie. I think last month we got the first Conjuring. I have both Conjuring movies. What I always do for my patrons, once a month we do a live hangout. We'll watch a movie together and I do giveaways. And I give away duplicate movies that I have. So it's always brand new movies and yeah, it's always fun. So this next question is going to be for The Conjuring. All right, question is for The Conjuring. What is the kill count in Commando? And the winner is at 106, Matthew Koenig. The actual answer is 109. Head over to the Drum Dumbs patron page to find out more about that. Plus, you get exclusive content. Like, I just went to Orlando recently, and I recorded a bunch of different horror sites around Orlando. Because there's, like, databases online. You can type in any city, and it'll show you horror locations. So, we went to Orlando, and I found, like, 7 different locations, and I recorded a video that I got to edit, and that's going to go on the patron page. Next up, we got a Cadaver Christmas. We got a Christmas horror movie here. Horror Pack Limited Edition Blu-ray. You'll only get this through the Horror Pack. A Cadaver Christmas delivers dark holiday laughs, Fangoria magazine. But yeah, we're always, I mean, there's not that many great Christmas horror movies. So, I mean, the ones that everybody goes to are Silent Night, Deadly Night, and Black Christmas. So it's always nice to add some new ones to the collection. And last movie for the month is Mother Krampus. This looks like one of those Walmart dumpster fire covers. I haven't seen this movie. This movie might be great, okay? But I love these covers. You know, like, usually when the cover's, like, really awesome, it means the movie might be bad. So we'll see. Mother Krampus, though, it's another Christmas horror movie. And that's thumbnail material right there. All right, you know what? Next up, I'm going to show you what I got for Christmas, okay? And then we'll do the fan mail after, all right? So I got 4 t-shirts here. This is one of them, Barry Kicks Ass, Tim Strode Stomach Pounder. I just wore this in my Wonder Woman review, and this is from Big Trouble in Little China, of course. Awesome John Carpenter flick, and he's got a little bit of Kim Cattrall lipstick on. I love this shirt. It's just really funny. Next up, we got a Big Kahuna Burger. Pulp Fiction fans will love this one. Tarantino fans. Did he have Big Kahuna Burger in more than one of his movies? I think he did. But yeah, it's a Big Kahuna Burger. This one was a surprise. I didn't see this one coming. This is the Matrix, White Rabbit. Or not White Rabbit, but it's just Follow the... Yeah, I guess it is White Rabbit. Follow the White Rabbit. And then this is one that I freaking love. Jell-O. Love that shirt. And it's heathered. Nice and comfortable. But I got a couple of Italian horror shirts because of this one now. Love that shirt, though. Couple movies to show you guys. This one is one that I get requested a lot to review. This is The Blob. Have not seen this movie yet. The Blob remake. And now I can remedy that. Everybody says it's really good, so I'm looking forward to checking this one out. Another one, April Fool's Day. I had this on DVD. I've already reviewed this movie. Love the freaking twist in this movie. But man, you can't beat a good Shout Factory Collector's Edition. Love that cover. So glad to have this one in my collection. And this is one that my son got me, actually. He was like, Dad, I'm looking for ideas for you. What can I get you? And I was racking my brain and I was just browsing through Amazon because movies, you know, deep cut horror movies are always a good idea. And there's this movie that had been on my mind recently called The Dorm That Dripped Blood with Daphne Zuniga. And so I told him, you know what, just give me that, Dorm That Dripped Blood, which he did. And I've never seen this movie. It's got like a giallo type cover. I don't think this is an Italian horror film though because Daphne Zuniga's in it, so I don't know. But yeah, happy to have that one in the collection. Next up, I got a new Roku. The Roku in our bedroom is a first generation Roku, and certain apps, especially like HBO Max, it has a lot of trouble handling. And the Roku Premiere, it handles everything nice and quick, nice and fast. And so I've been using this one. So I have three Rokus now, one in the living room, one in the bedroom, and then that first generation, I moved that into my den area where I call that my horror movie watching era. Jesus. Okay, got a couple vinyl here. This was a nice surprise. Eddie and the Cruisers. I grew up loving Eddie and the Cruisers. This movie is so good to me, so underrated. People don't talk about it enough. I have the VHS. I have the soundtrack on CD, and now I have it on vinyl. And yeah, I might have to throw some B-roll in here of this. Dark Side. That's some great music from this movie actually. Betty Lou got a new pair of shoes. Betty Lou got a new pair of shoes. Betty Lou, wow, wow, wow. And that's why I review movies and don't sing. Lastly, before I get to your fan mail, I got The Witch or The Vitch. This is a great freaking score by Mark Corvin. Mark Corvin. Can't wait to give this a listen though. It's just very atmospheric, creepy. The movie itself is just creepy as hell. And I like having good horror scores. So I have like a separate section of my vinyl that's just movie scores, and most of them are horror. And then I have another section that's actual music. One of these days, I'm gonna do an actual vinyl collection video. And I didn't realize how many vinyls I have now. Quite the collection, actually. Now, before I go into your fan mail, I did get a message from a James Mayer. And I mistakenly told him that I received his package and it was from the UK. And looking through my mail here, I guess I didn't receive it. I got his name mixed up with somebody else's. So I will definitely be opening your package, James, on the next drum box, okay? So don't think I'm not gonna open it on camera because I definitely will. Yeah, looking through these though, I did not receive it yet. And I hate that I told him I received it when I didn't. But James says him and his daughter, they watch my videos, which I think is so cool, and I really appreciate it. It humbles me when you guys tell me that not only you, but your families watch my videos. That's crazy to me. I can't handle that. But this one right here is from, I don't see a name on it, okay? So let me look in here and see if there's like a letter or something. It's a couple of DVDs, but I don't see a letter, so if you sent me this, please let me know, okay? This is Roadside. Never heard of this movie. Highly unnerving. Director of Contracted, Roadside, okay? And then Creepshow, which this is the movie I was actually about to buy recently, too. And now I don't have to. I got at least in DVD format. So whoever sent me these, Creepshow and Roadside, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. So this one is from Robert Schumann. I've known Robert Schumann for quite a few years, actually. So Robert, let's see what you sent. Thank you. So it's a nice Christmas card and a mask. And I've been looking for a stylish mask. I use the N95's masks at work. And it's a nice Christmas mask. Let's see what this looks like. I like it, Robert. Thank you very much. It's gonna keep me nice and safe too. Really comfortable mask too. And a nice Christmas card here. Says, Lee, I hope you like the mask. And there is one for your wife. It's a Christmas one. Your friend, Robert Schumann. So this must be my wife's. So I'll make sure I give her that one. And let's open up this other one here. Oh, now this is more like it, Robert. Oh my goodness. It's a Michael Myers mask. And then there's another, hell yeah. Okay, this one's from Dustin Egan. Let's open this up and see what we got. And it's a VHS. This could be from Some Neat because he did say he was gonna be sending something, and he usually sends me VHS. This is Santa's Sleigh on VHS. I noticed Piswell actually did a commentary on this movie, I think yesterday. So funny enough, I got it on VHS today. Piswell, eat your heart out. I got a card here from Suzette. Suzette's a dear friend from all the way from Australia. Known her for quite a few years. And she sent me that Die Hard card that's back there. And that's on my backdrop. I keep it on my backdrop. This one's cute. It's got a nice little bunny on the front of it. It says, Lee, I hope you all have a wonderful Christmas, COVID-free, and an even better New Year 2021. Sending love and hugs from all across the miles. Best wishes, Suzette. It's the last present. This is from Dave Vanderhoff, dear friend. It doesn't say his name on here, but it says, don't open till Xmas. And I remember him telling me, do not open this until Xmas. So I'm thinking this is Dave Vanderhoff, okay? Today is Christmas. So here we go, Dave. Got two nice presents here. Let's open this one first. Uh-oh, this feels like something Dave would send me. Yes, sir. It is from Halloween 3. It's a pumpkin mask. I'm scared to put this on though, because I hear if you put this on, snakes and bugs will crawl out of your head, out of every orifice. But look at that. Thank you so much, Dave. That's awesome. And then one more here. I'm thinking this might be some vinyl. Oh, yes. Adding to my Kiss collection, this is Kiss Animalize. This is a really good... See, I like the 80s era of Kiss just as much as I like the makeup era of Kiss. Both of them equally. I've seen the band twice, once with makeup and once without. I saw them on the Revenge Tour, and then I saw them on the Reunion Tour with all four original members in makeup. But this is a really good album, actually. A lot of great tracks on here. Heaven's on Fire, of course. Burn, Bitch, Burn. Under the Gun. Thrills in the Night. Missed so many good songs on Animalize. And this is the album with Mark St. John, who was with the band for like 3 minutes. And his hand, like, he had some kind of like condition with his hand where he couldn't play the guitar anymore. So they hired the guy and then they had to let him go. But he did play on this album. And there he is, right on the back of the album too, like right there at the top, Mark St. John. Man, I wonder what he's doing today. Poor guy. I mean, can you imagine that, being in Kiss for one album like that and then just, you know, you're gone into the ether. At least Vinnie Vincent had like a short-lived career after Kiss. But thank you so much, Dave. Thank you so much, everybody, for those nice gifts. Hope you guys all had a wonderful, wonderful holiday, wonderful Christmas. And thank you guys so much for all that you do for my channel. I appreciate it. Anyway, guys, be sure to come over to Killer Flicks, where we talk horror all day and every day, and on Fridays. We do Free Fall Fridays. Follow me at Drum Dumbs on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Letterboxd. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Have a great day, and Drum Dumb out.